Hey everybody, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO Space Police set from 1992. This is the Galactic Mediator. It was the big one from that series with 406 pieces. This was the flagship of what folks call Space Police 2. It was the first reboot and revamp of the Space Police series. The first series came out quite some time before this and they kept it going. They did a total of three versions of Space Police. You can see this is a good sized craft. It's got quite a bit of interior space in it. We will look on the inside of it. And it is intended to carry around some prisoners and also has a little bit of investigative lab section inside of it. You got your engines back here on the sides. Of course, there's a big old communications dish, although it looks like it also has an engine coming out of it, so I'm not sure exactly what's up with that. Got a couple of long antennae sticking off the back. I'm not sure how much offensive capability this thing had. Possibly these things on the sides were supposed to be launchers, like missile launchers or something like that. Possibly these are supposed to be laser guns, you know, cannons of some sort. A little bit tough to tell, but I feel like this is primarily a transport and command vessel. The main canopy section makes an interesting use of stacking of two of the same type of windscreen. I didn't realize until I got this set that those were designed to work that way. Works out pretty nicely, and you can open them independently. Get a nice cavernous space in there. However, it doesn't make for a very good kind of, you know, a attack helicopter style tandem arrangement, because if you set this guy down in there, he's not going to be able to see forward at all. He's completely way down on the ground. So this is more of just an extra window space, kind of gives you a skylight area. This down here, however, is a proper little cockpit, and it does have a small little console towards the front with a little bit of a scan going on there. There are four of these quarter octagonal dome pieces on the thing. They make for some interesting details, though I don't quite understand what they're trying to be here. Maybe it's supposed to be just an extension of the window section. It kind of terminates strangely, and this is open on the bottom. It's a little bit odd. I think it looks a little bit better when you peek around this side over here, and just kind of that view looks a little bit better. Very nice piece though to get in a transparent color. I think it's downright funny how many Space Police logos are on this thing. Count them, if you will. They keep going all the way back to the back, as if you didn't know what this was all about. This forwardmost rooftop one is intended to be removed. It acts as a bit of a lock to this opening door to the top, which gives you some access to the interior. Not much going on there. There is another one of those little console pieces in there, but that's pretty much it. Otherwise, you just have space to do whatever you want and add your own pieces to build up some interior detail. Farther back on the roof, you do have another area that you can open up to access another section on the back of more interior. And that has a little bit more going on inside, because there are a couple of kind of faux weapons on the sides over there, and you get another one over here. You could possibly see those as being non-lethal weapons, or they could be full-on laser blasters, or they could just be various forms of flashlights and sensor related things. The thing in the middle is actually a little land vehicle, and that can come out through a ramp in the back. Certainly not the first time LEGO did something like this on a spaceship. Nice to see that theme still going along. This is an interesting, different looking little land vehicle. It has these raised wheels on the ends, so this thing is able to kind of rock around, and kind of has a little bit of a tank style driving system to it, where you've got the extra clearance up front. You're supposed to put your pilot or your driver for it right here in the front. He doesn't really have any control sticks or anything, but you kind of have to imagine that he's reaching down to the panel in the front. This back here is kind of a suction lock sort of device, and that's to hold on to one of the prison cells or detainment chambers on the back of the ship. You can pull up this little lever on the side, which then allows the whole thing to rotate just a little bit. The whole wing rotates out, which drops one of these, and you get two. There's one on either side, completely symmetrical there, and you can transport these things around. These are what your bad guys would be transported in. So this is just a temporary holding cell that can then be transferred whole. Now, unfortunately, there are huge holes in this thing, so I could just imagine minifigures being able to get out through there, but you have to imagine, as the player with the whole thing, that it's all fully sealed up and has a force field that goes through the entire thing. This little land vehicle is supposed to back up to it and just kind of hook it from the side, and then that's how it would be able to carry it around. You do have to push down on the front, or you can just kind of drag it around, but if you want it to be on more than two wheels, you gotta push down on the front, and it's supposed to be kind of locked in with some sort of force field or magnetic lock or something that won't let this get away as you transport this to or from a land-based detention facility. To get a bad guy in or out, you just swivel this open and then place him in there lying down however you like. In addition to dropping the ramp in the back and also the jail pods, you can also separate the entire ship into as many as three parts. Yes, it's one of those multiple things in one sorts of sets. The entire front section comes off, something like that, and it'll also separate somewhere in the middle back here. There we go. Now, unlike with many of the vehicles and craft that LEGO has allowed you to take apart, there's not a whole lot of sense to this one. Like, why would you use this? What is the purpose of this hollow, empty thing? It doesn't look like it has any particular purpose. I'm guessing that this would be sort of an investigative area, so you really do need to add your own stuff in there. I can't imagine this flying on its own. This could be left behind as just kind of a temporary base of operations, a land-based base of operations, while you go scouting around in this. This makes sense to me to be just a little bit of a kind of a police car in space sort of thing. You see, it is actually covered on the back. All these little things down here can become like little thrusters and engines and things, but it's still a little bit awkward like this. I think the whole set just looks fine altogether. Of course, you can also keep any two of the sections together, and I think this looks okay, even though it's open on the back. Looks kind of like a van, like a space van of some sort. Just wish they had given you a little bit of a cover on the back, and some of those gaps in the windows are a little bit awkward too. Three minifigs came with this set, two space police officers. I think the center one is supposed to be a captain, you know, somebody of higher rank. Different prints on those, that's pretty cool. And then one solitary Blacktron bad guy. A very happy Blacktron bad guy. What a concept that was, the Blacktron, you know, marauding space bandits with smiley faces. Only LEGO could pull that off, actually having bad guys that just look really happy and wholesome. But it allowed you to switch things around and make them good guys if you wanted to, you know, because everybody just was pretty much on even footing. And all these have air tanks, which were continued all through to Space Police 3 and a little bit beyond that as well. Still very useful pieces, and there are no prints on the backs of the heads or the torsos on these. This was before that era. So this was pretty nicely done. Even though it was in the 90s, it still managed to hold on to a lot of the original classic space kind of design philosophy and flair. Some specific aspects of it do feel a little bit unfinished or odd, but overall, the whole thing front to back just makes sense to me. It makes a good toy, it makes a good display model. It's something to be proud of, I would say. Those are my thoughts about this one, but please share your thoughts in the comment section. Always good to see more different people's opinions. I'm gonna move on to building some more stuff so I can bring you even more videos. Thank you for watching this one. I'll be talking to you again soon.